it.
Yes, sir. We're officially back at it. Book Nice coming at you with a quick news update. Just putting a few things up here to remind myself that we need to delve into these topics a little bit deeper on this week's podcast. Not too long ago here, maybe 1 p.m. Eastern time, Mezco put up a pre-order for another one of their in-house characters, the Rumble Society Baron Benz and the Aquaticons set. I think Fabio kind of predicted this already. It was up and sold out in, I guess, about a little under a half hour, so we'll talk about this in detail on this week's podcast. I didn't even bother trying to pre-order this. Also, not too long ago, just a few minutes ago, I got an alert that Hasbro Pulse is going to be launching, or Hasbro is going to be launching Hasbro Pulse UK. So I know that's something big for all of our friends across the pond, so they don't have to worry about crazy shipping costs and trying to get things. They will have their branch of Hasbro Pulse on their side where they can order exclusives and what have you from. So that's great news for them. And just a few pre-orders I wanted to highlight. Don't forget that the Marvel Legends Red Guardian and Melina 2-pack is up for pre-order. Links for all of these things will be in the description below. The NECA Predator Ultimate Assassin Predator, the unarmored version, this is a deluxe figure, is up for pre-order now. Slated to drop in June of 2021. We talked about this on this last week's episode of the ACBA podcast, the Dragon Ball Z SH Figure Arts Cooler. This is an exclusive, is up for pre-order, slated to drop in September of 2021. There is a $12.50 non-refundable down payment that you will have to make. I did pre-order this and I wasn't even allowed to use my credit for some reason, but this is probably one that you don't want to sleep on if you're collecting this line. And we talked about this on last week's podcast as well, the Bandai Spirits Pacific Rim, the Black Atlas Destroyer figure. I believe there is an anime on Netflix featuring this particular Jaeger, if I'm not mistaken. Like I said, we did talk about this on the podcast. This is slated for a September 2021 release. And I don't get into too many 1/6 scale figures myself, but I could see how this could be attractive for some of you guys that do. This is the Interbay Locker Room 1/6 scale accessory set. Obviously, you can use this with your other Interbay basketball themed figures. This pre-order is slated for the fourth quarter of 2021. And Happy Cat Industries, the same people that bought you the Foodie set that we were promoting and selling for quite some time, that we're still selling actually, are offering two new accessory packs. So this first one here is the Super Action Stuff Firepower Action Figure Accessories, and you can see everything that you get there. A little bit cheaper than the Robot Spirit sets that I've been promoting for a while. This is in stock and ready to ship right now. And then they are also offering the Super Action Stuff Bag of Violence Action Figure Accessories as well. So a bunch of different blood splatters and stuff here, and some melee weapons, I suppose. This is also in stock and ready to ship now. And last but certainly not least, in terms of pre-orders, late last night, the Marvel Amazing Yamaguchi Rebel Tech Iron Spider went up for pre-order. This is slated to drop in July of 2021. No hesitation on my part. I definitely scooped this up. I have been falling back a little bit on Rebel Tech stuff. I've said this a couple times, but I do have the Captain America figure and I see what they were going for, trying to get us to recreate that iconic fight between Iron Spider and Captain America during the first Civil War. And this thing looks like a beast. We talked about this maybe 3 or 4 episodes back on the podcast. And I talked about the upcoming MCU WandaVision Scarlet Witch that's supposed to be dropping yesterday. And I saw this image of Vision floating around, but I wasn't sure if it was authentic or not. I suppose it is. I see that Marvelous News reported on this, so I would assume we're going to get the White Vision variant here, which would probably be based on the Vision we already got from MCU. I'm not 100% sure on that, but I guess these would be cool to own. No idea on a specific release date for either just yet. Yesterday, March 9th, was the anniversary of Biggie's death. That's why I did that extended play in my video late last night of one of his freestyles there. I talked about this on last week's podcast too, but I would highly recommend, and I actually mentioned it on my Instagram yesterday too, but I would highly recommend that if you're a fan of hip-hop, a fan of Biggie's, that you check out the documentary that they have on him on Netflix right now. It was really good. A few weeks ago, I think exactly 3 weeks ago, I put up a news video breaking some rumored or some leaked news about upcoming Fantastic Four wave, the possibility of a second wave of the AOA figures from Marvel Legends, and a rumored Spider-Man wave for 2021. And now this image is floating around the net with what looks like the case assortment. We still don't know what the Build-A-Figure is here, but mostly MCU figures for this wave. I assume that this may drop around the time that the movie is going to come out, and that's probably why. Looks like one comic-based figure and one Gamerverse figure. So again, we still waiting to see what the Build-A-Figure may be for this. And for more information about the other stuff I reported on, I'll link that other news video in case you didn't check it out in the description below. But I'm feeling like we're going to get a null Build-A-Figure. I've said this in like 3 or 4 videos over the past month or so. And speaking of null, I actually just finished up Absolute Carnage last night, which leads directly into The King in Black, where Null is the overarching villain. So looking forward to that. Also finished up my Dragon Ball Z Frieza and Goku versus Jiren shot last night. Pretty happy with the end result here. Little BTS for you on my way out of here. And I did actually just get a few packages in too, so I'm looking forward to getting back on the table tonight. Gonna complete my Toy Biz Build-A-Figure Apocalypse. Got that package in, and I also got Jace from the Ginyu Force in. That's my cue. But thanks for hanging out. As always, rate, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell down there. And until next time, peace.
Laugh now, cry later. I rhyme greater than the average player hater and spectators. Buy my CD twice. They see me in the streets. They be like, yo, he nice. But that's on the low, though.